Hi there guys, and welcome back to another writing video. I'm going to be doing something I have not done in quite a while. We are going to have a little talk. So I got my drink of choice. I have my coffee. It's almost all gone, but I still have a little bit of coffee left from Dunkin' Donuts, my all-time favorite coffee place. I want you guys to get your drink of choice, and we are going to have a little coffee chat and talk about writing. I mean, it's my favorite thing to do, just to drink coffee and talk about writing. And there's a subject that I don't know. I think it'll be interesting to talk about. So today we're going to be talking all about why I stopped writing YA and the reasons I don't write YA anymore and the reasons I don't want to, don't think it's a good idea. So if you're not sure like what YA is, it actually I'll just say it one time. YA stands for young adult. It's kind of the term in the writing world for young adult literature. And actually, a lot of people don't know this about me, and I actually realized this the other day at school. I was talking to someone, and they assumed that I started off writing horror, and that actually could not be further from the truth. My first books were actually children's books. I started out writing children's books. If you didn't know that, or you want to hear more about that, how I started writing and how I got from children's books to horror, definitely let me know in the comments below, and I will do a whole other video about that. But I did not break into horror until around book 16 to 20. I was very into children's books and YA. So I know a lot of people assume that I'm like, oh, you write horror, you always written horror, but that actually is not correct. I started in writing children's books. So now that we got that squared away, let's talk about YA. So YA is young adult fiction, like I said, and it's basically teen reads, for lack of a better word. Young adult fiction is usually, it's kind of the in-between between, like, regular books and, children's books. And I call them teen reads, I just call them that. They're usually about books for ages between 12 and 18, usually, like, teenage reads, with subjects that aren't as heavy as adult books, but subjects that are, like, to age. And, I have more experience reading YA than I do writing, but I'm going to talk a little bit about both. I just want to apologize for my hair, first of all, because I got my hair done today, and they curled my bangs. Yeah, I do have bangs. I'm trying to hide them and grow them out, but I used to have bangs in middle school, and I cannot stand having my bangs curled, so I tried to fix it, and it just does not look good. Anyway, enough about that. Oh my gosh. So, my first experience with YA is, I used to think that I wrote adult books at like 11. I started really getting into writing novels at around 11. 11-year-olds don't really know adult topics, if you guys get what I'm saying. I thought I was writing adult, but looking back, it was completely YA because I did not know things. I thought I did, I didn't. I mean, at 11 years old, you're just learning how stuff works. I had a lot of 11-year-old friends that didn't even know the birds and the bees yet. So I want to say that until I turned about 15, I was writing YA because that's what I knew. I was a child. I was a young adult. So, of course, I was going to write that. Now, in 7th grade, I was very into reading. I never liked children's books. I'll just get into that. I went from, like, Goosebumps to Stephen King overnight. I did not enjoy children's books. Okay, well, that's actually not all true. I did enjoy reading The Pony Pals. Putting that out there. But I went kind of overnight, and in 7th grade, well, how old are you in 7th grade? You're turning 13? You're 12 to 13, I think. It's been a while. I was really into reading Stephen King books. I was really into reading books such as, like, I really liked reading Garth Stein. I liked reading Dennis Lehane. I think I read a couple of Dean Koontz's books. I was just really into reading adult books, and my teacher wrote on one of my assignments once, like, I think you're reading a matter that is too grown up for you. You are 12 years old. You need to read like you are 12 years old. Kind of that I wasn't really reading appropriate stuff, and I kind of got bothered by this because in my head, I was like 25. I didn't feel 12. I never felt 12 because of, like, outside situations. And so I went to my mom, I was like, I don't want to read kids' books. She's like, it's okay, we'll go to Borders. Oh my gosh, who remembers Borders? We'll go to Borders and we'll pick out stuff. So I had to go through all the teen books and all the YA, and I managed to pick out a few that I liked. I really didn't like much of them, but I had to read them. And then afterward, I was going to start writing them. And I did write a lot. And like some of the examples of the YA books I wrote were like What Sunshine Brought Together, The Island of Forgotten Dogs, Fear of the Unknown was YA, Sister Sitters was YA, My Heart is in the Mountains, like a bunch of books that you'll never hear me talk about and that I will never talk about. Those are all YA. And going into Fragile was YA, and I had some books that were adult. They started that way. Ghost of the Sea, I don't really think there's any way Ghost of the Sea could ever be for kids under 18 because of the subject matter, but Fragile actually was started YA. And the subject matter of Fragile is really dark. I'm gonna be honest. I sometimes don't consider it dark because I don't like to consider myself having lived a dark life, even though I know in a lot of ways I have. But I don't think of my life as dark, so sometimes I don't think the some matters such as like suicide and self-harm, they're dark because I'm like, I don't think my life is dark. But when I wanted to pursue publishing Fragile, I did get some advice like parents will not let their kids read this because there are subject matters such as rape, bulimia, teen pregnancy. That's not gonna fly in the YA world. Maybe it's touched on a little bit, but the detail and all that, it's not going to be okay. And that around that time when I heard that is when I decided that I wanted to venture away from YA because I really wasn't happy with the guidelines. Also with like the length. Lengths are a lot shorter in YA because like kids don't want to read that long books. I didn't. I certainly didn't. That's kind of one of the reasons I didn't read It. One of Stephen King's books because I was kind of intimidated by how big it was as a kid. So I didn't read the book and I was really bad and I just watched the movie or the TV series at the time instead. That was number one because of like the length and everything, and I did not like being in guidelines. I didn't like feeling like I was in a box. When Guilty of Love came along, I at first thought I was writing YA. But there's really not a lot about Shania and Blair's relationship that would be appropriate for someone who is 17, 16 years old. Statutory rape and that whole concept, that's not okay for kids. And I didn't want to have to scale myself back to writing material that is age appropriate. And I started realizing that as I got a little older because I had my best friend's a few years younger than me, and when he wanted to read my stuff when he was like 14, I was like, no way. And if I didn't even feel comfortable with him reading my stuff at 14, how would actual parents feel okay with their kids reading my stuff? I just really didn't like how I had to scale back for a young adult. And with young adult, now I know this is gonna be a very it's gonna be like a lot of controversy behind this comment, but I'm gonna say it anyway. When you're writing YA, you're technically writing for the parents because whatever you write, the parents need to be okay with. Whatever you do, the parents need to be okay with. They're the ones buying the book. They are gonna need to be okay if when their kids are reading it. You don't wanna write a young adult book about suicide because you don't want a child reading that and then their parents seeing it and being like, WTF, I don't want my kid reading this. Which has happened to me. And has happened to friends I knew. I did read the book Suicide Notes that I loved it when I was in grade school or middle school. And I don't think my dad was cool with me reading that. And just a lot of you're technically writing it for the parents, so they need to be okay with it. And a lot of the subject matter that I enjoy writing is not going to be approved by that. Whether or not I agree with that is not the issue. Do I think that children should be able to learn about suicide and eating disorders from a young age to help awareness? Absolutely. Absolutely. Am I the parent who's deciding that? Absolutely not. So as much as I think that those are my beliefs, I don't really get a say with that because it's not my kid reading it, and I am not like in charge of all that. So that kind of is my whole point. Going on to, I was told to dial it back in a matter of words all throughout my childhood. I was told I was dark. I was told you need to be a kid more. You need to do this more. You need to be more age appropriate. You can't be talking to this. You can't be telling your friends about this. I was told the teachers I was too intense. I was told you can't be talking about suicide. I was told you can't be, like, you're too depressed, like, all that. Everything you can imagine, I got in middle school, I got from the middle school counselor. Like, I can't even get into what they, all the things that they have told me over the years. I would never want to bring that into my writing and have those, you can't do this, you can't say that, don't do this, don't do that, in my writing. And I feel like if you're writing it for a certain age group, you need to do that. That kind of goes with what I was saying about having to dial it back. So I really don't want that. And I think for me, adult is a lot better because I'm not really good at scaling myself back and I'm not really good at that. And I want to be able to write freely because writing, I write for you guys, obviously. I write books, but mostly I write for me. And if I'm not writing something that I'm getting something out of, if I'm not getting that therapy out of my writing, then it's not doing the job for me. And I need to be able to write and, like, purge my, I don't like that word purge, but purge the words from my body and get everything out. And I just didn't feel like I was getting that with YA. And I don't really like the subject matters that are going in. I've done a lot of research about YA and I really don't like the subject matters that they deal with. So I've always just, adult is just better for me. It's better. I think I write better with it. I don't have the, like, limitations of having to scale back, and I get to speak my mind because one of the best things I can do is go dark. And there are some things I still need to dial back, and I get that in school because I'm very intense with my writing. But it's just a lot much better of a fit for me, and I can explore more of the topics that I like because, I mean, I've read a lot of YA horror, and some of it's really cheesy. Some of it's really good, but some of it's really cheesy, and I want to be able to do the horror that I like to do and not have to worry about, like, people not finding that appropriate. And I think at an older age, like starting at like 18, people are more mature to deal with issues like that. Because if you have a 14, happy, bubbly 14-year-old, they shouldn't have to deal with reading about suicide and sad things. Because if you have a happy child, you don't want to expose them to dark and depressing topics. I know I wouldn't have wanted to if I didn't have to deal with it. But so yeah, it's kind of like my whole take on YA and why I stopped writing it, and I'm really glad I did because I'm enjoying writing, like, for adults more. And that doesn't mean, I was gonna say, that doesn't mean you can't have teenage characters because a lot of my characters are very young, such like the Fragile Girls. Fragile and Shania is very young, and a lot of my characters are young, but just because you're writing a teenager doesn't mean the teenagers are gonna watch it. I am a teenager still, but I mean, I watch a lot of shows, most of shows with adults in it. I used to watch teen shows when I was about like 13. I watched teenagers, but not that much anymore. But my mom watches teenage shows and she's like a lot older. So just because you're writing teenage characters doesn't mean your audience needs to be teenagers. I mean, you could have grown dads liking the show. It doesn't really matter because that kind of, like, who's gonna like it has always been kind of stereotypical in my mind because, I mean, you don't need to fit a quota in order to like something. You like something because you like it. Whether you're 8 or 13 or 25 or 45, you can like whatever you want to watch. And if you're a grandma enjoying a teenage show, more power to you because I think people should be able to enjoy whatever they like. So that's kind of, that was such a big ramble. That's kind of all about why I don't write YA anymore and why I decided to stop writing YA. I still have some of this left. I can't believe it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and as I mentioned before, I am planning to do a Q&A. Keep leaving your comments down below. Say, like, question, comment for Q&A, and if you want to ask a question anonymously, feel free to leave it on my Tumblr. Just put, like, for Q&A, and I will be answering your question soon. All right, thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I'll talk to you guys next Wednesday. Bye!